Okay, so when we talk about absolute value, which comes up a lot, believe it or not, in actual real life, absolute value is defined as the distance from zero. Okay, so the reason when we see these bars, the answers always come out as positive is because this one says, how far is negative 5 away from 0? It is 5 units. So the answer to that is 5. But how far is positive 5 from 0? Well, it's also 5. So what those bars are referring to is a distance from 0. Keep that in mind. Algebraically speaking, if it is positive, it's exactly the same value. But anything you have in here that's negative, if it's less than zero, you also have a negative possibility, okay? Meaning you can have these numbers, but it just has to be from zero. So you can have two possibilities is the point. Meaning if you have a problem like this, absolute value of x minus 8 equals 20, then you have two possibilities. 20 is the distance from zero. So you can have like, if you had a number line and here were zero, then x minus 8 could be this far, but it could also be this far, and that could both be 20. So you have two solutions. What you must write each time you do these is x minus 8 equals 20. That's going to give you your right-hand solution. Or to get the negative or the left-hand solution, you're going to do it this way. The opposite side, that's the negative, is also equal to 20. So you have to do both cases. One, two. One's to the right, one's to the left. You must do this step. This must be written. You cannot do this in your head, please. Okay. Now, then you solve each equation. So I'm going to add 8 to both sides, and here I get x equals 28. And here I have to distribute the negative, so I get negative x plus 8 equals 20, right, because I have to distribute that. I'm going to take away 8 from both sides, and the possibility that I get is x equals negative 12. So in set notation, what you write is negative 12, comma, and 28. Those are the two answers that you get when you solve that equation. And you just write it as a set. B. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to add 3 because I want this absolute value thing alone. So it's actually equal to 2x plus 4 absolute value equals 3. And then I can write both of my equations. So 2x plus 4 equals 3, or the opposite of 2x plus 4 equals 3. Both of those will give me a solution. So here I take away a 4 from both sides, and I divide by 2 because x is being multiplied by a 2. So I get x equals negative half. And over here, I distribute my negative. I'm going to add 4 to both sides. I'm going to divide by negative 2 to undo that multiplication. And I get negative 7 over 2. So again, as a set, it's negative 7 over 2, negative 1 half, because that's the smaller number, so I always put it to the left in order, just like that. So that's two examples. Now, we have some special cases. That's just like normal, okay? But in the case where there are a couple things that have no solution, right here it says negative 6. The absolute value of x equals negative 6. We don't have any absolute value less than 0. You can't have negative direction. Or distance from zero. You can't have negative distance from zero. That's what the definition of those bars are. Thus, say thus. There is no solution to this. So if you have absolute value equal to a negative, that is no solution. And you can see in D, see in the example, I'm going to take away 5 from both sides. And then again, no matter what this is, there's no positive distance from 0 that will give me negative 5. So there's just simply no solution. And for both of these, for set notation, you would just write an empty set. Okay. No solution. You could also write out the words. And then last, special case, we have something that just doesn't work. But if you get two solutions, one of them works. And that's called extraneous. Okay, extraneous means you get two answers, but they're not solutions, because a solution makes it true. An answer doesn't necessarily make the original one true. So we'll solve this. X minus 8 equals 3x minus 4, or the opposite of x minus 8 equals 3x minus 4. So solve both of these. I'm going to take away an x from both sides. And then to get x by itself, I'm going to add 4 to both sides. So negative 8 plus 4. And then I want to undo that multiplication. So I divide by 2, and I get x equals negative 2. Over here, first step, distribute my negative. And I'm going to add x to both sides. Now I'm going to add 4 to both sides. And finally, undo that multiplication by dividing both sides by 4. So I got two answers. If I take the 3 and put it in here, I get 3 minus 8, that's negative 5, which would be a positive 5. And then I put the 3 in there and I get 9 minus 4. So this one works. However, if you take negative 2 and you put it back in here, you get negative 2 minus 8 equals 3 times negative 2 minus 4. So this would be negative 10. And this would be negative 10 also, but the absolute value of negative 10 is not negative 10, it's positive 10. So this one does not work. It doesn't give you a true solution. So if it doesn't work, you know what we do? We just cross it out. And our only solution then, the only thing that will make it true, is 3. So you do have to look out for the single solution. And we are going to practice these problems on pages 14 and 15 in your packet. Please, please, please make sure if you have any questions, you ask them while we're working on it.